13th February at dusk, RAF Lancaster swing their way toward Dresden in a massive blow involving more than 800 heavy bombers. A new type German Scarecrow bomb explodes in midair, simulating a direct hit on a bomber. Pathfinder flares and incendiaries mark the immediate targets. Scarecrow bomb. The attack is in support of Russian armies moving toward this rail center on a front 50 miles away. Tons of bombs are dropped during the night attack. 2 days later, AAF flying fortresses follow up with a second assault on this German communication center. Tons of explosives are aimed at what remains of the freight yards. Prior to the war, Dresden was a city of 625,000 population. The double blow is estimated to have virtually destroyed the entire city. RAF planes over enemy territory on 22nd February. Typical day of all-out Allied bombing. The RAF bombs highways and viaducts. Every type of RAF combat plane is used in this onslaught on German transport, troops, and communications. Heavy bombers from the 8th and 15th Air Force groups strike at rail targets. Rocket-firing typhoons peel off to strike at enemy installations and supplies. Sorties are made, and more than 6,600 tons of explosives are dropped during this single day of all-out bombing and strafing. On 23rd February, the following night, the German industrial city of Pforzheim is hit by more than 400 RAF bombers. Using a new bombing technique, Lancasters lay some 10,000 4-pound incendiaries to mark the target. Then they drop anything from 500 to 12,000-pound blockbusters. In 20 minutes, the raid is over. The town of Pforzheim is completely destroyed. On 2nd March, 700 Lancaster and Halifax bombers roar over Cologne to block roads and railroads leading across the Rhine and to destroy concentrations of German troops fleeing the city as the American First Army smashes into it. Fourth largest in Germany, now a pile of rubble and shattered buildings. A German Scarecrow bomb demolishes a Lancaster. Strategic targets are hit without destroying the Cologne Cathedral, which still stands amid the ruins.